Thank you for joining the 10th annual Candlelight Vigil by BCFS Health and Human Services Del Rio. While we have always been encouraged by so many members of our city showing up to this event each October and recognizing the victims of domestic violence together, this year we must find unity in a different way. As you will see in today's vigil, domestic violence is one thing a pandemic cannot stop, often bringing more tension into the home. Today, we will grieve the members of our Del Rio and Texas communities that we lost this year and commit to doing what we each can to end suffering caused by violence in the family. Thank you for being here.
La violencia en contra de las mujeres es una grave violación de sus derechos humanos. Mujeres y niñas migrantes mexicanas enfrentan discriminación y violencia, incluyendo violencia intrafamiliar. ONU Mujeres y la Secretaría de Relaciones Exteriores de México crearon el Protocolo de Atención Consular para Personas Víctimas de Violencia de Género. Nuestra ventanilla de atención integral a la mujer, VAIM, escucha, orienta y canaliza a mujeres mexicanas para que reciban atención psicológica, legal y de empoderamiento. Por ello, las invitamos a visitar el Consulado de México para, con sensibilidad, identificar situaciones de vulnerabilidad. Y recuerda, no estás sola, la VAIM te tiende la mano.
Un saludo a todas y todos. En nombre de mi gobierno, agradezco que nos hagan partícipes de este evento tan importante para conmemorar las vidas que se han visto interrumpidas injustamente por la violencia doméstica. Problemática global que requiere una transformación profunda y un abordaje integral. En este contexto, Guatemala en el año 2000 creó la Secretaría Presidencial de la Mujer como entidad que asesora y coordina las políticas públicas para promover el desarrollo integral de las mujeres guatemaltecas, marcando el camino para fortalecer el posicionamiento de este tema en la agenda pública del país. En el año 2016, se activó la Coordinadora Nacional para la Prevención de la Violencia Intrafamiliar y contra las Mujeres, CONAPREVI, mecanismo rector en las políticas públicas para el abordaje integral que reúne diversos actores de gobierno. Asimismo, como parte del esfuerzo internacional, Guatemala es parte de la Comisión Interamericana de Mujeres, CIM, órgano intergubernamental establecido para promover los derechos humanos de las mujeres y actualmente es el principal foro generador de políticas hemisféricas para la promoción de estos y de la igualdad de género. Estas acciones han buscado el fortalecimiento de la institucionalidad vinculada al desarrollo integral de las mujeres guatemaltecas y han contribuido a mejorar las políticas internacionales de protección de la mujer. Pero sin duda, aún falta mucho trabajo por hacer. Las expresiones de violencia contra las mujeres son tan diversas como los ámbitos en los que se dan. Y las medidas de confinamiento durante la pandemia han exacerbado la problemática. Además de la presión de ser consideradas las mujeres como principales responsables de las importantes actividades de cuidado, sin las cuales esta sociedad no funciona, la pandemia suma el teletrabajo y la educación virtual, profundizando las desigualdades de género en lo familiar, laboral y social. Finalmente, como representante de la República de Guatemala en esta comunidad, reitero nuestro compromiso para sumarnos a todos los esfuerzos que contribuyan a la evolución de las mentalidades y condiciones estructurales que marginan el desarrollo integral de las mujeres. Sin duda, ni una más ni una menos. Muchas gracias.
Every year, millions of people all over the world are victims of domestic violence and abuse. If you or someone you know is in a situation that is unsafe, know that there are local resources and support available to you or them. Domestic violence can be a difficult situation to talk about and more so to escape from. It can happen to anyone. No one is immune to domestic violence. In honor of the BCFS 10th Annual Candlelight Vigil and Proclamation, we honor the brave individuals who walked away from an unhealthy situation, but especially those who lost their lives too soon to domestic violence. Please know there is always help. There is always a way out. Each time you stand up for yourself, you stand up for all those facing the same challenges. Together, we are stronger.
Hello, my name is Mari Carmen Garza, and I'm the Victims' Rights Group Coordinator for Texas Rio Grande Legal Aid, TRLA, or TRALA, as many of you know it. TRLA is currently celebrating the 50 years of serving low-income Texans across 68 counties along the Texas-Mexico border. As a native of Del Rio and Acuña, I was deeply honored by the invitation of BCFS to celebrate with you the 10th annual Candlelight Vigil. Tonight, we gather virtually to raise a candle, to light our candle for all those who have perished at the hands of those who promise to love them. We also light our candle for the families whose lives were shattered by the impact of domestic violence, and we hold them in our light. Every October, advocates across the nation raise awareness during the month of October to shed a light on the tremendous impact that domestic violence has on everyone. We raise awareness because we know it is preventable. 1 in 4 women and 1 in 9 men report to have experienced severe domestic violence during their lifetimes. 20 Americans every minute are being abused physically. The impact is tremendous, and we might feel like we're isolated, but the truth is that we are not. Every year, the Texas Council on Family Violence publishes a report called Honoring Texas Victims. In this year's report, which was only published a couple of weeks ago, a native Del Rioan, somebody from Del Rio, from our community, appeared in this report. And I will read you her story because it's important that we remember her name and know the facts. Her name, Amanda Riojas, 27 years old. Amanda Riojas died when her boyfriend, Robert Evans Jr., 26, shot her in a vehicle parked at a convenience store. Evans fled. Authorities arrested and charged Evans with murder and tampering with evidence. Evans has a history of abusive behavior towards Amanda. Amanda is survived by her 3 daughters and 2 sons. Amanda died on April 26, 2019. Domestic violence is preventable. You can do something about it. You might ask, what can I do? First, believe survivors when they tell you they are scared, when they tell you they are not safe in their homes. It is very important and crucial that we believe them. Right now, we are in the middle of a worldwide pandemic. And while we might be safe in our homes, the home may be the most dangerous place for many who suffer domestic violence. TRLA, our domestic violence intakes, have just skyrocketed during this time. There's not enough attorneys for the demand of help to try to end an abusive relationship. Our partner shelters report the same. Enormous amount of calls, yet nowhere to go. So what can you do to help besides believing survivors? Support the organizations who are trying to help individuals financially, volunteer, spread the word, spread the message, and then do something about it. I know this is a hard topic. It is very difficult. And often the community reacts by asking, well, why doesn't she just leave? And I'm saying she, knowing that men are also impacted by violence. The reason why people stay in a relationship is very multifaceted. First, leaving may be the most dangerous time for a survivor, a victim of violence. The report honoring Texas victims, which highlights the lives of all those who died in 2019 and every year before that, the report documents those who perished. Every year, 30% in the minimum are the individuals who had reported to their abuser that they were leaving, had left, or had just filed for divorce. So leaving could be the most dangerous time, and it is the most dangerous time for victims. So if somebody is seeking and ending a relationship, it is important that they speak to those who know this work so they can help them find a way to leave safely. Another reason why victims don't leave is the economics of it. Oftentimes, the finances are so entangled with that of the abusers, if they have any at all. It is hard to find a place to live when you have no income, no credit. When you have left the workforce to be full-time mom or housewife. If you have been isolated and cut out from your family and friends, how do you start over? Maybe you don't even have a vehicle to leave and to go somewhere else. There are many, many reasons why a survivor, a victim, may stay in a relationship. And we should not blame them for that. We should not be asking, why doesn't she leave? We should be asking, why does he not stop using violence against her? It's important that we think about this as we retreat to the safety of our homes every evening to avoid a pandemic. Support, give hope, and believe. We can do this together. We can combat and end domestic violence if we come together as a community to do everything that we can to stop it, because it is 100% preventable. Again, I thank you for allowing me this space to share with you. And I send my most sincere and heartfelt condolences to all who are suffering right now for their loss of their loved one. And I want you to know, if you are in a domestic violence relationship right now, that there are people who care and who want to help you. Please reach out. Thank you, everybody.
I know we are only human. Something changes when you're livid. I try to make sense of all your rage. When I'm down, you knock me further. I'd like to think I was stronger. I try to make sense of all this pain. But what am I if not a footprint in the sand? It goes away when blows it into place. But what am I if not flesh and blood in your hand? I was made for you. I belong to you. Hold me tight. don't have a chance now. I've lost my ground. I'm falling down, and you are my only line. You're my worst fear. I'm underground. I'd like to think you would save me. Something in my heart says maybe. Something in my soul is screaming no. I am crying at your feet now. You think this is funny somehow. You have turned my worth into a joke. Hold me down, 'cause I'm falling fast now. I don't have a chance now. I've lost my ground. I'm falling down, and you are my only line. You're my worst fear. I'm underground. I know we are only human. Something changes when you're livid. I try to make sense of all your rage.
Eugenia Anaya Espinosa Nava, 32, Kyle. Jessica Velasquez, 36, Grand Prairie. Tracy Lavelle, 44, Victoria. Jenna Scott, 28, Killeen. Sharanjit Kaur, 52, Irving. Samantha Drago, 30, Waco. Danny Kennedy, 53, Elmendorf. Stephanie Smith, 52, Mesquite. Jessica Sanchez, 37, Divine. Linda Karcher, 72, San Antonio. LaDonna Garcia, 48, Richardson. Patricia Ruedas, 45, Midland. Brittany Reardon, 21, San Antonio. Champagne Woods, 28, La Mesa. Cassandra Benitez, 20, Conroe. Andrine McDonald, 29, San Antonio. Bridget Fort, 39, Denton. Daria Kuzanov, 27, Lake Conroe. Josephine Ramos, 36, San Antonio. Jade Harris, 20, Ponder. Tina Kappa, 52, New Caney. Alyssa Willis, 62, San Antonio. Jessica Cantu, 36, San Diego. Sergio Perez, 24, Sunray. Janice Bassan, 16, San Antonio. Jose Melendez Hernandez, 48, Odessa. Curtis Washington, 51, Nacogdoches. Marisa Jernigan, 20, San Antonio. Tiffany Paulvin, 35, Odessa. Paula Watson, 56, Corsicana. Samantha Marie Cantu, 27, Edinburgh. Lee Grijalva, 26, El Paso. Priscilla Davila, 32, Corpus Christi. Unnamed, 62, San Antonio. Jasmine Marie Castro, 18, El Paso. Dolores Salazar, 36, Corpus Christi. Mary Lou Rodriguez, 26, San Antonio. Erica Gaitan, 29, El Paso. Eddie Sorkinaka, 48, Flower Bluff. Brenda Tony, 69, San Antonio. Monica Carrasco, 24, El Paso. Vanessa Vecina, 36, Petronila. Aide Rueda, 33, San Antonio. Amy Contreras Colbert, 27, Fort Bliss. Epimenio Cabrera, 50, Robstown. Gabriela Rodriguez, 24, San Antonio. Brandy Cano, 22, Richmond. Michelle Steinman Davis, 24, Millsap. Willis Sanders, 63, Texarkana. Jenny Hongen Nguyen, 35, Richmond. Kenneth Walker, 61, Weatherford. Jessica Taylor Sullivan, 34, Alvin. Shanti Nakirankanti, 46, Sugarland. Erica Sanchez, 30, Bovinia. Katrina Charles, 39, Lake Jackson. Kiva Herrera, 38, Sugarland. Ashley Delaney, 27, Blanchard. Trisha Rodriguez, 39, Lake Jackson. Susanna Newfold, 40, Seminole. Barbara King, 71, Segno. Anita Scott, 43, Pearland. April Murdoch, 33, League City. Aaron Carter, 27, Amarillo. Belinda Hernandez, 52, Pearland. Chantel Bernard, 42, League City. Richard Garza, 30, Amarillo. Thea Flakes, 39, College Station. Timothy Joe Stout, 65, Kilgore. Isabel Hernandez, 44, Pecos. Aaliyah Hutchinson, 22, Baird. Christy Nicole Perez, 38, Longview. Holly Jones, 37, Henderson. Raquel Salinas, 42, Dimmitt. Kimberly Wallace Medford, 39, Longview. Harold Klein Glaze, 63, Tenaha. James Baker, 52, Charlie. Brianna Lundrum, 24, San Marcos. Karen Monteaguado, 47, Winona. Jimmy Ferris, 72, Plano. Jesusita Loredo, 46, San Marcos. Wassam Musa, 23, Arlington. Deanna Kihei, 51, Cedar Hill. Graciela Torres, 66, Cypress. Dale Blake, 65, Nova Scotia. Alyssa Rogers, 24, Arlington. Yvonne Perkins, 37, Cedar Hill. Karen Finney, 32, Fort Worth. Miles Rogers, 93, Coppell. Rochelle Salazar, 34, Highland. Catherine Kirk, 55, Fort Worth. Wetsin Garcia Mireles, 26, Dallas. Diane Schneider, 58, Hockley. Sheila Rowland, 71, Fort Worth. Belinda Sue Foster, 66, Mabank. Oscar Reyes Alvarado, 17, Houston. Vanessa Mayfield, 31, Fort Worth. Sheila Prater, 45, Dallas. Jeremy Ray, 21, Houston. Vincent Smith, 54, Fort Worth. Kristen Carey, 43, Dallas. Maricela Davila, 35, Houston. Elizabeth Moore, 60, Grand Prairie. Segunda Glosson, 31, Dallas. Cindy Romero Fajardo, 32, Houston. Mary Baxter, 40, North Richland Hills. Rona Deldren, 58, Dallas. Michael Thomas, 56, Houston. Emily Susan Teeter Law, 40, Huertuga. Jennifer Choice, 32, Dallas. Melina Lopez, 23, Houston. Diane Marie Cole, 63, Huertuga. Gina Elder, 40, Dallas. Walter Oliver, 64, Houston. Roberto Espinosa, 26, Mount Pleasant. Kendrick Stewart, 19, Dallas. Adelina Diaz, 34, Houston. Michelle Lee Bragg, 50, Mount Pleasant. Andy Longoria, 47, Dallas. Carrie Nebden, 40, Houston. Juan Angel Zapata, 38, Austin. Urania De Jesus Flores, 34, Dallas. Tiffany Uzar, 40, Houston. San Juana Macias, 40, Austin. Gretchen Easton, 45, Dallas. Shamla Burks, 34, Houston. Francie Martinez, 41, Austin. Diana Garcia, 22, Dallas. Rita Hargrove, May, 45, Abner. Robin Hatcher, 52, Austin. Jaime Thiepen, 72, Dallas. Melissa Villagrana, 38, Kerrville. Amita Mahaller, 23, Austin. Jacqueline Rose Nichols, 32, Dallas. Letitia Smith, 39, Littlefield. Veneranda Gutierrez, 36, Austin. Latoya Johnson, 31, Dallas. Jada Lillite, 24, Halesville. Diamond Bridgman, 29, Austin. Layla McDaniel, 38, Dallas. Maria Isabel Cervantes, 19, Lubbock. Kara Cardinal, 42, Orr City. Mason Varela, 21, DeSoto. James Olson, 38, Hewitt. Amanda Riojas, 27, Del Rio, April 26, 2019.
Fell for it. I put you first and you adored it. Set fires to my forest and you let it burn. Sang off key in my chorus, 'cause it wasn't yours. I saw the signs and I ignored it. Rose-colored glasses are distorted. Set fire to my purpose and I let it burn. You got off in the hurting when it wasn't yours. Yeah. We'd always go into it blindly. I needed to lose you to find me. This dancer was killing me softly. I needed to hate you to love me, yeah. To love, love, yeah. To love, love, yeah. To love, yeah. I needed to lose you to love me, yeah. To love, love, yeah. To love, love, yeah. To love.
Thank you to all of our elected officials and community members who made a big effort to adapt with us to the new format for this year's Candlelight Vigil. Your commitment to this cause, I hope, empowers South Texas as you do us at BCFS Health and Human Services Del Rio. I want to leave you with one final piece today, a memorial for Amanda Riojas. Amanda lost her life last spring due to domestic violence, and her mother, Rosemary Gutierrez, was kind and strong enough to join us at last year's event to talk about Amanda and about what we can do together to end domestic violence. Let's now remember the life of Amanda, and that for every victim like her, there are family, friends, and children left behind who did not have to be. Thank you again for joining us. Here is Amanda's memorial.